listen, you made my eyes.
One, two.
So I can see, you made my arms.
One, two.
So I can praise you, you made my heart. So I can love. Every word I speak, every thought I think, everything I do, my whole self belongs to you. You made my hands,
one, two,
for helping others. You made my feet,
one, two,
so I can follow you. You made my legs,
one, two,
to jump for Jesus. You made my heart, so I can love. Every word I speak, every thought I think, everything I do, my whole self belongs to you. Every word I speak, every thought I think, everything I do, my whole self belongs to you. My whole self belongs to you.
Building homes and things for people, but I wonder what I can do to help. What type of work I can do for God. Maybe today's Bible story might help.
It's time for our Bible story. Our story today comes from the book of Acts, chapter 1. But this book isn't about an axe. It's about actions, the things that we do. This book tells the story of the works of Jesus' followers who started the church, guided by the Holy Spirit. Our story for today finds those very followers facing a tough question. Do you know what Jesus' band of followers were called? They were called disciples. There were 12 of them, and each of them had an important role. Sadly, one of them, named Judas, made some bad decisions that led to Jesus being captured. His actions caused him to give up his role as one of the 12 disciples. It was sad, and it upset Jesus and all of the disciples, but they couldn't stay sad. There was work to do. After Jesus died and came back to the disciples one last time, they knew that the good news of God had to be spread everywhere. And in order to do that, they needed to find someone who could take on the leadership that Judas left. It was a big decision. They narrowed it down to two, Justice and Matthias. The truth was, the decision was too big for them to make. So they went to the Holy Spirit in prayer, believing that that would lead them to the right person. After praying, they cast lots. Casting lots was basically like rolling dice, but they weren't depending on casting lots to tell them what to do. They were depending on the Holy Spirit to make a call. And in fact, that's exactly what the Holy Spirit did. Matthias was chosen to take Judas's spot. Just like Jesus' disciples, we all have work to do for God, like telling others about God's love and what Jesus did for them. But we can trust the Holy Spirit to help us with the work and any tough decisions we need to make. The disciples did that, and so can we, because the Holy Spirit helps us do God's work.
I got it! I got it! I thought of something I can do to help others too! My dad reminded me of a place where I can pack lunches for other kids who don't always have all the food that they need. We're going to go together this week. The kids who get to get the meals go to school where I go to school, and they get to take the food home. It will help them take care of themselves when there isn't enough. I can definitely help others by putting the meals together and praying for their situations. They are kids just like me. I am so excited I can do something for God in my own way. What are some ways you can do God's work? Let me know next time, okay? Remember, the Holy Spirit helps us do God's work. Thanks for growing with me, friends. Peace out.
Amen. That's right, children. Why don't you sing this song together with me? Let's do the actions.
Holy Spirit fills me up. Fills me up until I overflow. From a timber to a cup. From a river to a deep blue sea. Holy Spirit lives in me.
Let's sing that one more time.
Holy Spirit fills me up. Up until I overflow from a timber to a cup.
Romans 8:14. For those who are led by the Spirit of God are the children of God. Romans 8:14. For those who are led by the Spirit of God are the children of God. Romans 8:14. For those who are led by the Spirit of God are the children of God. Romans 8:14. For those who are led by the Spirit of God are the children of God.